What's up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Trucks Only. I'm Harvey from Hutch's Welding. Here to showcase a little product development project. We got a 72 F-250 Camper Special. Plan on doing like a budget lift slash leveling kit for this. As you can see, this thing's got like an epic rake. No, it's not ready for drag racing. A big problem is there's really nothing available for this to do any kind of lift. I mean, there are some lift kits out there, but you gotta kind of replace the whole thing. So I have an idea of making some radius brackets and some pitman arm brackets that are just kind of new drop. They're drop, but they're actually gonna lift the vehicle and do like a coil spacer to kind of give it a budget lift slash leveling kit. But in the meantime, just kind of talk about the truck. If you're wondering why the fender's off, reason the fender is off is because this side was actually smashed in. Did buy it, not running. These engines are really solid. They don't really need much. This is a 390. It's got nice, you know, factory AC. Basically just got it, threw a carburetor on it because it's been sitting. The carburetor was locked up, so that is a Holley two-barrel replacement carb. You know, your standard plugs, wires, cap rotor, ignition coil. The radiator was busted and leaking, so we, you know, just threw like an aftermarket aluminum radiator in there. That's pretty much it, and this thing fired right up. Transmission good, rear end's good, brakes are good. Other than that, this thing runs really well, actually. Obviously need some floorboards. You can see that side's, you know, pretty busted up. Interior is pretty cool. I actually like it, like this little olive color. I actually believe they call this avocado. I do want to try to save this seat. Maybe try to find someone that can kind of redo it. I've talked to a couple interior guys, and I've heard some rumors that a lot of guys get tricky and will actually take material from the backside, which unfortunately this does not have. But anyway, we'll take material from like other parts and kind of reapply it. You know, it looks like the piping's good and the stitching's good. Just kind of redo all these things. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. I did find another green seat. It's not the exact match, but it is another green seat that we'll kind of do for now. So we'll figure that out. So this is a Camper Special. As you can see, it had a nice little plug here. It's got the tie downs, two tanks. Overall, a nice truck. So like I said, just picked it up for some product development. Figured bob around town a little bit, clean it up really nice. One thing, I thought the paint was actually still in really good condition. It's like just not, you know, it's a good solid patina. So one thing I wanted to really do with that is preserve it. I'm all about patina and kind of bringing the paint back. So what I did is I called my main man here, Chris, which oddly enough, his last name's Hutchinson. So, you know, he thinks he's the real Hutch, but really he's, you know, yeah. He's Hutch 2, T-O-O. You know, if you're interested in maybe kind of bringing back, you know, an oldie, where can we find you?
Extremely Detailed Services on Instagram.
Okay, Extremely Detailed Services. I'll drop a link for that.
I specialize in high-end cars, exotics, vintage classics. I'm a car guy just like you. I've been doing this a long time. I've been detailing since I was 12. That's how I earn my allowance, and it's a passion.
That's awesome, man. Yeah. Thanks for coming out here. You want to kind of run us through what you got going on? And
yeah, so I just want to say that, you know, I'm just trying to find the right process to get this to your liking. This is new to me too, so I'm just trying to attack it in the way that I know how. Just trying to knock down some of this blistering to get it kind of to like this point, you know, where it's all kind of faded, and then hit it with some, you know, big bite 800 1000 grit compound, but I'm using 800 1000 wet sandpaper to get it all, the blister all taken care of and all leveled, and then we'll buff it out and throw a coat of wax on it and get it to look, see how there's, you can actually see.
Yeah, I can actually see a reflection here, which
is depth. If you look close enough when the sun's out, you can actually see some metallic in there, which is kind of crazy.
That's amazing, actually, that you can bring it, you know, bring it back. I mean, you can see this is like pretty dull.
Yeah.
And I didn't really know much about this. I had him come by just kind of take a look at some things, and he actually was telling me that a lot of this you can bring back.
It's very dehydrated, so as long as you know, throw a coat of wax on it just to hydrate a little bit and see what you're working with, and then go from there, like wet sand and buff and all that stuff. it'll come back. It's just trying to find the right process, because every truck's different. I don't know how many coats of clear on here. There's got to be a bunch of different ones. And the clear back then, so much different than the clear nowadays. It's all soft nowadays. It's all rock hard stuff.
Gotcha.
That's why it still has clear on it, you know?
Right, yeah, it's very amazing that you can, I was amazed that you can even do this.
Yeah.
I've seen guys, on the real rough patina stuff kind of bring it back, but on surfaces like this where it's still somewhat there, you can bring it back to life. I mean, you can see, probably hard to tell, but it's shiny.
The sun's coming out right
now. It's freaking shiny, man. It looks like it's got a clear on it, but that's just
metallic.
Now this is just buffed over, no wax, or it's got wax?
This is actually, I buffed it with like a 800 to 1000 grit, and then I put a coat of my wax on it, and that's it.
Cool.
And I'm just going back and wet sanding all the blister spots to try and level them so they can all look uniform, like how this looks.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, that's
so
awesome.
Once I
man.
Buff this bottom half, it'll look exactly like this, or hopefully that's the goal. And then once we know that process, then we can duplicate it on every panel and make a few changes here and there based on the clear coat level and stuff like that.
But yeah, we're not trying to bring it back, show quality, but we're just trying to bring it back. Obviously a lot of these spots, they're kind of an eyesore, so if we can kind of blend them, give it some shine,
easy on the eyes.
Yeah, make it easy on the eyes, give it bring that patina back, get that old school kind of look and feel, kind of bring it right back. I think that's pretty much it for this. We'll touch base back on this when we get a little bit more progress going. So you guys stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Enjoy yourselves. Dude, that came out super sick.
It looks so good.
You can see it.
Yeah, now you can see your reflection, man. That's awesome.